Welcome to the show. My name is Anisha with a T. We're chilling right here at the Cup Kisementi, and it is another edition of One on One right here on Urban Television. Now today I happen to pull out one of the persons that you see me with every Saturday on Double Trouble, the man who is always dissing me and giving me a hard time. But I was like, why not bring him? I'm sure people want to know more about him, what he's doing with his life, why today he has decided to comb his fro. Welcome to the show, Deejay Crim.
Thank you very much, Anisha. I'm here. You know, I've been hearing about your show, just hearing. Mm. But finally today, I'm here.
You know
and
that,
trust me, let me tell you, this is going to be your biggest interview.
It better be.
On this show. Uh-huh. On this show. Mm. Because you're working with the mogul. They call me Deejay Crim, the turntable guru, the mogul. I'm here, Urban TV. Stay tuned.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Katika soka to kubuza, which car do you drive?
I drive.
You know the thing is that
no.
I like no.
Ask Crim.
No, Crim.
Crim.
Before you even start the show,
yes.
Let's do this. You know, you started off telling us he's a mogul, he's got money.
This show
is going to be entirely a sincere show, but we want the truth. Oh boy, now we have a taxi, we'll start to gabo vuga. We don't want us to tell us that we're in a Benz. So what kind of car do you drive?
I want you to say cars you have.
Okay, what cars do you have?
Yeah. Uh-huh. I have three cars.
Uh-huh.
And of course, two of them are Benzes.
Uh-huh.
And one of them is just a taxi.
Oh.
Yeah.
It sounds like a lie, but let's get into the real thing. First of all, Crim.
Yeah.
What is your real name? Because people will see you turntable guru,
yeah,
but they don't know.
People watching up on TV, they call me Agaba George Crim.
Mm.
I have three names. I'm from Barara.
Mm.
Of course, the biggest boys come from Kashari.
Mm.
That's how we be. I don't want to mention the big names.
Yeah.
That's where we come from.
Mm.
And of course, I was born and raised in Kampala, where we make them holler.
Mm-hmm.
I don't bleach and snitch like a cliche. I'm here.
This guy came with rhymes.
Did I prepare for this show?
Oh
no.
God.
No, I didn't prepare for this show.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
But honestly, behind this whole persona that you put up, you get it, there has to be the humble beginnings, you know, and there has to be someone that you're willing to inspire, someone you're willing to look, you know, someone that you look up to, but also other people you're willing to inspire, not so? So let's talk about your humble beginnings. Watandi Kirawa.
My humble beginnings, let me take it musically, because this is a musical television.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with everybody, me, I started from church as a church boy, as an altar boy.
Mm.
I was that kind of, that sweet guy who was always in the you know, the soprano, you know, soprano bass. The soprano,
so you can
guy.
Sing?
I do. And that's, I'm back into singing.
Mm.
Yeah, I'm back into singing. So all in all, I was an altar boy. I was even, I was one of the people who won our church, St. John's Church. I grew up from Chitintale. So St. John's Church, we won like our choir, the Chitintale choir, we won an award, like we're the best choir in the competitions.
Yeah.
I think that was my first award I got. Yeah, but I'm so grateful.
Mm.
And imagine, I still have that picture, New Vision put us like the best choir back in the day.
Mm.
By the way, I'm a very old guy. I'm making 30 years.
This
Friday.
This Friday we're talking about something new, that something that you put up.
Yeah.
I like to call it that you're a very smart man. Not only will you be working,
but
you'll be entertaining your fans. You'll be putting it out there. So this Friday you have your birthday party.
Yeah,
it's going to be at Lit Lounge.
That's
and I have to be there, and the people have to be there. You have
obviously
to celebrate how old you're getting. 40 years old?
No, I said 30. Man,
uh-huh.
I'm 30.
Mm-hmm.
How do they, Kabaka says 30 and young. Mm. Well, how do they say for the Kabaka?
That is our Kabaka. You can't compare yourself to our Kabaka. So let's first talk about Lead Lounge. You don't only do a birthday there, you do so many gigs.
I do so many gigs. Talking about my life, man, you know, after doing a lot of business, like after the choir thing, I was like, let me go into music, like seriously. So I went into music, I started producing. I used to produce music with my sister, who is in Germany right now. So I was into producing. Producing wasn't bringing in the money.
Yeah.
I was like, what should I do? Because I come from a poor family.
Yeah.
Whereby I used to pay for my own school fees, my own dues and everything. Because my dad at one time, he couldn't manage. So I was like, what should I do?
Yeah.
Then I was like, let me gamble everything. I started DJing, learning. One good thing, there's a guy called Peter who helped me out.
Mm.
And my uncle, they helped me out. They had LPs and everything. And I learned how to DJ, how to connect equipment.
Mm.
It was a lot. So I was into singing, I was into producing, I was into everything, like I was gambling, until I got myself into the music industry and the DJing bit of it.
Mm.
And the DJing was giving me at least 10,000 shillings and I could survive at school. My parents could bring some of the money.
Mm.
Then we joined and they paid my fees. So I managed to study and studied and studied. But this was my side business from back in the day, from high school, from even primary, everything.
Yeah.
Like since I was young, I was into this business. So don't wake up and you say you can do what I do. Mm. I'm just warning you. But anyway, let's leave that aside.
No, you know, honestly, like I said, when I began the show, I said, you know, people know you as this man with money, but they didn't know this side of you. And that's the reason we have you on the show, because they didn't know that you had a hustle.
I don't have that too much money that Brian White has, that they expose. I have that little money that can help a street kid. That little money that can help somebody who wants to start a Rolex business, and I can give it to you. I have that money.
Do you give it to the people?
I do. Let me tell you, I've helped so many people. I don't want to talk much. I get kids off the streets, take them and I teach them how to DJ so they can earn some little money. DJ Crim, I'm not going to expose myself about that.
Mm.
And God is paying me in a good way. Amen. And I'm happy about that. I give back to the community. But anyway, if you know me, you know. So I don't want to go there. Where am I? Let me go straight to Lit Lounge.
Mm-hmm.
This Friday, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and everybody, if you know you love DJ Crim, the brand itself, it's going down at Lit Lounge in Bukoto. The DJ Crim birthday showdown. You know the first one was in Club Play.
Mm.
And the second birthday showdown was in Red Eye Lounge.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, this third one, we're taking it to Lit Lounge.
Mm.
I'm not going to make anyone pay money.
Mm.
No. It's free entrance.
Ofunira so muwa.
Nze sibi akufuna mu singa byali byakufuna mu.
Yeah.
Tivula ba. Jino mikisa. So God is rewarding me. Abantu njaba jeba nyumirwe. These are my people. I'm going to play for them music. And let me tell you, artists who are performing, there's so many.
Wow.
Munji, my brother is coming.
Mm.
Vinka is coming. That's an obvious case.
I was going to say something about Vinka and Barbarita.
Don't say. Oh, Barbarita is coming.
Nwaji.
Nati Nathan is coming.
Mm.
Sheena Skies. I have a song with Sheena Skies. Mm. We are premiering two songs.
Mm.
One is called Kampala.
Speaking, let's cut you off a little bit.
Yeah.
Speaking of all these musicians,
yeah.
DJ Crim is a superstar, not only on the turntable and things like that, but also you have this music that you keep releasing. I stalk your statuses.
Yeah.
And you're like coming up, releasing three songs. Yeah. What? You're doing, cooking
you,
up things
let me
in
tell you,
the
I told you,
studio.
I'm blessed. How am I blessed?
Mm-hmm.
God gave me this talent. I produce my own music.
Mm.
Alongside other producers, which is okay.
Yeah.
Like, I do the records myself. I compose these songs myself.
Mm.
If there is anybody who says that, Crim, I'm the one who wrote for you this song, please, come up.
Mm.
When we get to the videos, I call up Pest. I want to do this video. It's like this and this. I direct the video myself. If it's fake, vague, it's okay. But
no,
it's myself.
Cut it right there.
Yeah.
Cut it. You've talked too much. Wanted to take over my show. But you know, Crim, with this kind of attitude, how are people? You need people. You can't be there, bad, vague, I'm DJ Crim, all that. Too yambi.
Let me tell you. I one time you have to be that AKA. One time you have to be that Kabebe cool on the other side. You know what it means? Kubanga kan kubulide. Wogira abantu bakulinyako ebisele bizimumu. Abantu bakulinyako nga jamanyi who are you? Okitegeera nze byempisemu bingi nnyonyonyo naye saagala kubiraga kati bantu bangi kankubuli. Let me tell you one thing even about DJs. I find DJs in a bar, some of them. I pay for them drinks, but when I take my music there, they don't want to play my music, man. I don't know, because if I'm, I don't know, I did the biggest song.
Do you want to tell us some
no
of
names,
those?
No names.
No names at all?
No names.
I thought toti abantu.
See what you come. It's so come by Singapore.
Uh-huh.
That's same by Singapore.
So,
same by Singapore.
Before we take a quick break, because we have to take a quick break.
Yeah.
Tell me, are there any DJs you look up to in Uganda? What, like top three DJs?
Nah. And he said, don't take me there. There's no, in Uganda, there's no DJ who does what I do. If it's there, the light is there. Show me. Is there any DJ? The light is there. No DJ. Come on, Anisha.
So there's
Let's
no...
go. Let's just go for a short commercial break and come back. There's no DJ who does what I do. I told you I'm a mogul.
So honestly speaking, no. Calm down, Crim. There is no one.
There's
who
no.
You look up to.
No. They
Everyone
look up
is
to
better
me.
Than you. Everyone.
they look up
should,
to me.
Should you put you up for a challenge one time?
Please do, put it even tomorrow on Friday.
Actually, let's do this. You say that you're up for any challenge and call for a break in a few minutes. do it.
Yo, my fans. Please, if you know you go to any club around Uganda, please, and you know there is a DJ who's good.
Better than you.
Better than me. Please, forward the name and let that DJ come. We battle it out. That's very simple.
Mm-hmm.
And we finish it up. And you, the fans, will judge. Easy.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's getting breezy. Okay. Let's go for the show commercial break, man. Get out of here.